I want to thank ORConf organizing committee for the kind introduction, and also to thank my colleagues Alexander Kamkin and Mikhail Lebedev for their participation in this joint work. Okay, I'll talk about the formal verification tools for HDL descriptions. In formal verification, the main goal is to check formal properties on the system description in a quick, correctly, and easy to use way. So as open source penetrates in our life in forms of operating systems, instruction sets, and so on, and so does formal verification tools, they become more powerful, more strength, and so on. Even there are some attempts to apply such tools to industrial examples, and not only academy but commercial companies provide their solutions, their suits for formal verification. In this talk, I'll concentrate on tools that are based on model checking techniques. I think most of us know what model checking is, but I'll remind it in a couple of words. Model checking allows to set the correspondence between the formal model of the system and the set of specifications that are formal properties. During the model checking, the special tool called model checker tries to generate a counterexample, which is a sequence of input stimuli that moves the formal model from the initial state to a specification contradicting state. Model checker may even return some errors or say that it can't generate counterexample, but the main problem here is well-known state explosion problem. So we need to optimize our models to transform them in some way to check real big systems with these tools. On this slide, I have tried to picture some classification of existing model checker tools in open source field. There are at least three families of tools. The first one implements such a synthesis-based approach when the HDL description at first step translated into the netlist representation, and model checking is started from that step. One of the first tools here was ABC. It is still actual and powerful enough. It is aimed at netlist descriptions checking and have some possibilities to elaborate Verilog, but only a subset of, as I think. One of the famous conceptual childs of ABC, well, there is an IOSIS framework on which several model checker tools are based. I'll describe two of them lately that are called Symbiosis and Verilog to SMV. Another family of model checkers are based on software verification techniques. That is a line of tools started from CBMC. CBMC is a software model checker. From that tool, several instruments has grown, like VCGAR and its newer version called EBMC. And finally, there is a number of tools that use external model checkers. They just translate HDL descriptions into their format. So here I have tried to show such model checkers here. The first one, and probably the famous, is SMV. It was written in early 90s by Ken Macmillan. From that tool, also several tools have grown, like new SMV, new SMV2, and new XMV. Here there are two model checkers that use such programs. It is Verilog to SMV again, and our tool called Retrascope. The main question in my research is, are these tools good enough for industry? Are we able to apply them in our projects without limitations? We have made a series of experiments to check how these tools support Verilog constructions and how successful they are in formal property checking. We have selected four tools for these experiments. The first one is EBMC, the Enhanced Bounded Model Checker. It has been developed by the Daniel Kreonik team in Oxford University. Next two tools are YOSIS framework based. The first one is Symbiosis, a front-end driver program for YOSIS suite. As far as I know, it is written by guys from Clifford Wolf team, Austria. Next tool is called Verilog to SMV. It is a translator from Verilog language to SMV-based model checkers format. It is developed by Bruno Kessler Foundation team. And the last tool is our tool called Retrascope. It is a framework for reverse engineering and translation of HDL descriptions. And the next couple of slides will be concerned about our tool. But before, a small overview of tools. Here, you can see some of their characteristics, what inputs they take. In this talk, I will concentrate on Verilog language, but some of the tools, at least our tool, support VHDL. When I looked through the program of the ORConf, I have found that probably Symbiosis is able to check VHDL, so I wonder, is it possible or not? One thing I should note here also is that EBMC is, well, actually not open source. It is free for academic use and maybe for some else use. It's distributed in binary form, but we took it for experiments also. So a couple of words about our toolkit called Retrascope. It is an extendable framework for HDL descriptions parsing, analysis, visualization, and verification. The main three subsystems Retrascope includes are a couple of engines, a number of models, and library part. Engines are active components that perform HDL descriptions parsing, model extraction, and functional test generation. So Retrascope is capable to combine different engines into tool chains to produce different hybrid verification techniques. There is a number of models the Retrascope toolkit use. That some of them are classic, like control flow graph. There are some also exotic models we use that are extended finite state machine, guarded actions, and so on. On this slide, the main flow of the Retrascope toolkit is shown. The first step is code analysis. It is performed in a classical compiler-like way and finishes with building the inner representation that is based on control flow graph. From the control flow graph, different engines are capable to derive different models and to use them for the different tasks like functional test generation, visualization, and model checking. After we have selected model checkers for our experiments, we should to find some benchmarks on which we try to compare them. It's quite a long story of benchmarks growing. The early benchmarks didn't contain HDL descriptions at all because they was aimed for synthesis tools testing. But now we have a lot of HDL benchmarks in VHDL, in Verilog. We have open course website with plenty of such collections. So for our experiments, we have selected three quite popular benchmarks that appear in several research papers. Here they are. It is Texas 97 benchmark and benchmarks of VCGAR and Verilog to SMV tools. All these benchmarks contain several numbers of Verilog models and some properties we have tried to check with tools I have discussed above. So the first series of experiments was quite simple. We run every tool on every Verilog model, collect the results. After that, we have applied reference compiler for Verilog descriptions. We have selected model sim starter edition. Model sim produced errors on some designs. We have fixed them and run model checkers again on already fixed designs. So every tool return one of the four results on every model. Well, okay, when there were no errors, it returned error when error is detected in erroneous Verilog. Sometimes tools have detected errors, but the Verilog code was correct, so it's not error actually, but the fail of the tool. And for some models, model checker just crashed without any expectations. So here is the result of the experiment. Gray lines mean, well, for every cell, a number of models is shown on which the related tool demonstrates the related behavior. Gray colored cells show the results for original Verilog models. Other cells show the results on fixed Verilog. So here I have tried to find some, well, you know, leaders which fails not so much as others and find errors only for wrong Verilog models. We have found a number of Verilog constructions that are correct, but that are unsupported by model checkers. So EBMC doesn't support assigning inputs to regs or outputs, and it also doesn't support task system call without any parameters. As for EOSIS-based tools, they don't support two or more complement declarations of the same signal. They don't support uninitialized variables and different types of left and right sides of assignment. The second series of experiments was concerned about property checking. Our benchmarks contain very small properties in the form of a system Verilog assert property. So it's just non-temporal conditions on internal variables of Verilog designs. EBMC doesn't support such constructions, so for that tool we have rewritten benchmarks in the pure Verilog manner. We have set time limit as 1 hour, and we used bounded model checking mode for all the tools. The bound value was set to 100, and also we have collected the responses from tools. Three of them are the same as for Verilog support experiments, and we also have three new behaviors. It is false behavior when the property is false and model checker has returned a counterexample. It also can say that property is true and there is no counterexample, or just bound is reached, so no counterexample has been found. And finally, for some designs, model checkers just tell nothing because of time limit expiration. Well, so here are the results of the second series of experiment. EOSIS-based tools was unable to check properties separately. I mean, when in design there are two or more properties on the same model, model checker based on Yosis return just the overall result, and as far as I understand, isn't able to show which properties were false and which were true. From that table, we can see that Retrascope has found the maximum number of counterexamples, and it also best in bug detection on the Verilog syntax. As for other tools, the most stable tool is eBMC, so there is no crashes at all for the tool. Also, it is a performance leader. It means that there were only two cases for that eBMC overgrow the timeout. So, and symbiosis is quite close, so these tools are fast enough. We also took some case study. We took a dispatcher model from Intel Quartos Prime suite. It is 2200 lines of code, 8 submodels, and our customer provide us with a top-level checker with a number of system Verilog properties. And unfortunately, only Retrascope is able to check them, but with a small bound, about 10 ticks, I think. Other tools were unable to parse the code of the dispatcher. eBMC shows that it doesn't support def param construction and doesn't support local values for parameters. As for symbiosis, it have some issues in parameter redefinition, and so does Verilog to SMV. So to sum up, our experiments show that open source model checkers still have issues, both in Verilog and system Verilog language support. Also, some of them have performance issues, like our tool, Retrascope. The main cause is the using of external model checkers, like new SMV. So here we need to either to optimize our formal models somehow, or make a deep dive inside the new SMV model checker, for example, to fix and to optimize its code somehow. Also, I think there is some kind of mess in open benchmarks field. It's not such simple task to select an adequate benchmarks. I think here we should somehow measure the completeness of these benchmarks, maybe standard-based completeness, and so on. On this slide, you'll see our contacts. You may take our tool and its source code. We will be glad if you provide us with some feedback about it. Oh, that is all. Thank you.
If you give me a couple minutes, I've got several different questions. The first one is back on page 13. You had 13. Said 13, yes, please.
Yep.
Two or more complement declarations of the same. What does that mean?
For example, if you write input X variable and after that write wire X in different lines. Well, I have used symbiosis of at the April of 2019, I think. Maybe the last patches have fixed that.
And what do you mean by it does not support uninitialized variables?
I mean that these tools report errors when variable doesn't have initial value at all. But as far as I know, Verilog standard say that it's okay.
Only if you have an assertion that depends on the initial value. Then the assertion will fail if you haven't given it an initial value. You can also use a there's an option to suspend assertion evaluation for a clock cycle if you want to use the first clock cycle as a reset. But let me go on. I had a question on 15. You said page 15.
Yeah.
You were talking about how fast or slow things were. You didn't mention which solver Symbiosis was using. Symbiosis supports probably about 6 different solvers, and they all have various different timing issues associated with them.
I think there was some standard solver. I didn't specify some.
So that would be the YSIS solver then, from, I forget who. YSIS tends to be the standard. You still have to specify
maybe.
It's an SMTBMC solver if you're going to go that road. Okay, let's see. The other question was unable to check properties separately. I'll leave that one there. Let me go back to slide 16. You talked about def param. My question about def param is, as I understand, def param is a deprecated part of the language, and so it's not supported for new designs, if you will. Can someone correct me if I'm wrong? I've seen a lot of statements about def param shouldn't be used anymore. So I know, well, that's my problem. I've seen it used, but yeah, exactly. That's sort of my question, thought, comment there. I don't know if that's a disagreement or just something I might note.
Well, I think that for that case, model checker should, in a more correct manner, to describe to user that the cause of the error is not in code, but in deprecated construction using. EBMC doesn't do such thing. It just crashes and without any explanation.
Painful. Thank you. Thank you.